Thank you guys for joining us here today on BZB Express TV. If it is your first time actually catching our channel, we appreciate you guys joining us. Remember, hit that subscribe button so you do not miss out on any future episodes. Now today we will be covering video wall processors and showing you guys all the cool things you could do with this awesome technology. We will be unboxing and demoing four of the top brands in the video wall game. So stay tuned. You don't want to miss a thing. All right. So what exactly is a video wall? Video wall is a multi-monitor setup consisting of, you guessed it, multiple monitors, projectors or TVs, all tiled together to create one giant display. Now, the types of display technologies used include projection screens, laser phosphor displays, rear projection cubes, LCD and LED panels. Now, having multiple displays to form a video wall is one thing. However, we are still going to need a video wall processor to make all this magic happen. So let's go ahead and unbox four of the brands that we carry and see exactly what they have to offer. Awesome, we are now balling with the video wall. Nice job, Chris.
Thank you.
Hey, can you actually put it on one big ass screen?
Absolutely, man, that's the point of these video walls. Yeah. Let's see what she looks like.
There you go, man. Even awesomer. Hey, can you put like on each screen, the own scene and rotate it a little? And I am talking to myself now, folks. I guess it's lunchtime, but I am here for you guys still. Video walls are useful in stadiums and large public venues, such as airports, although they are not exclusive to just large venues. While the display is certainly the most visible, it is only one piece of the entire solution. If you ever wondered all about the technology behind a video wall and how all the screens communicate with each other to create one single display, and basically how they all work together, that's exactly what we will be covering in today's episode. So, first up to bat, we have AvenView's ProWall. The HDM2 ProWall T4K is bundled with its own control software for easy configuration of layouts such as 1x1, 1x3, 1x4, 2x2, and Mosaic. This unit is capable of 4K at 60 or 1080p with rotation, different presets, and custom layout. The control software will also allow users to resize, position, zoom output video, choose resolution, and adjust bezel correction. Looking at the back panel, we have our power switch and power jack. We have a USB port for firmware updates, Ethernet port, stereo audio output, our HDMI input, which connects to your sources, whether it's a gaming system or what we're using is a Sony Blu-ray player. We have a DIP switch here to activate your firmware updates. Lastly, we have our four HDMI outputs, which are all going out to our four TV screens. Besides the control software, you can control this unit via its front panel buttons, like so, or through its IR remote. Now, if you want a larger video wall, you can cascade this unit through software with multiple units to create a bigger video wall, such as a 3x3. The HDM2 ProWall T4K works great for retail digital signage, education facilities, commercial applications like broadcasting, and even surveillance systems. It's also one of the more compact units that we have today that we are exhibiting on this episode. So let's move on to our next video wall unit. Hang tight while we connect it to our displays. The second unit that we will be demoing is the Geffen EXT UHD 600A VWC 14. This device can accept a single 4K 60 444 HDMI source and send that to four equally sized 1080p full HD displays. Now we will be using the Xbox One S as our HDMI source. Now come follow me and we'll do some simple demonstrations for you guys. Now I'd like to first point out that this unit does have a versatile bezel accommodation feature, which will accommodate any display bezel widths. All right, so I mean, it has many different types of features and presets with the display. You can actually take the picture and rotate it in 90 degree increments individually or simultaneously. So let's go ahead and demo that real quick. All right, so as you can see on our HDMI output one, display one, let's go ahead and start rotating the display. So yeah, it's pretty cool. You can orient your picture as, you know, any orientation that you like, any direction. You could also edit the horizontal and vertical preset layouts. So let's go ahead and do that real quick as well. Like for instance, we have a vertical 4x1 preset. So this is ideal, like if you have your displays set, they're oriented vertically and you have your menu, you can easily, you know, edit that from here. You also have, along with a vertical 4x1, say you want to do a horizontal 4x1, boom, you can have that also. Let's go ahead and put it back to our normal full screen. There you go. As you can see, I've been using the front panel buttons to control the Geffen unit. It also comes with handy dandy IR remote. You can use RS-232 as well as IP. To avoid any accidental, button presses, you can press and hold the menu button and it will lock all front panel functions. You can also access the unit via an easy to use graphical user interface for system configurations. As you can see, the unit is 1U tall and can be easily mounted in a standard 19 inch wide rack like what we have here. All right, so let's go down, see the ports. Here we have the power jack. We have our USB port for firmware updates, IP control, our Ethernet. We have an audio output for separating your audio from your HDMI, your HDMI input, which is connected to our Xbox One S, RS-232 port. We have our four HDMI outputs, which are going to our four TV screens, and an IR port. Now hang tight while we go ahead and install and set up our next video wall controller. The third unit that we have up is the ShinyBow 3403. The 3403 is a dynamic unit with creative video wall configurations. It allows predefined playback modes, unlimited cascades, and friendly OSD operation. So let's go ahead and try a few things with this unit. Now before we get into the demo, let's take a look at the front panel. Now right off the bat, I've noticed compared to the other units, there really are no front panel buttons. They're all replaced with dip switches. Okay, so let's start off on the left. We have our power switch, reset button. Here we have our main inputs that you could switch between, which are HDMI, DVI, DisplayPort, and VGA. Now this next input, the PIP, picture-in-picture input, is a very cool feature that we'll get into more during the demo, but you can also switch between your PIP inputs here. We have our bezel settings, picture-in-picture settings, our display modes, and our status light indicators. One thing to note is that whenever you are changing the dip switch selections, you will need to power off and on again the unit to implement these settings. As we take a closer look, you can see our four outputs for the four TVs that we have it connected to. Our various inputs, we have our HDMI hooked in. We also have a loop out for an HDMI. We have our display port and DVI VGA input. We have a port for RS-232 control, IR extender, and our power supply. Let's get into demoing the ShinyBow 3403. We mentioned before that there really aren't any front panel buttons. It's probably because they put all the buttons on the remote. Looks very intuitive. A lot of the buttons and functions seem to be on the remote itself, so very easy to use. So let's go ahead and start playing with the presets of the video wall layouts. All right, let's go into output mode. And as you can see, there are an array. There is an array of presets here that you can play with. If you want to rotate them all vertically, you can do that. You can have the picture, you know, angled if you have your monitors angled to a certain degree. Or you could just have each picture equally displayed on all four displays. Now, an awesome feature with the ShinyBow 3403 is its PIP capabilities. This unit does do picture-in-picture. Not many video wall controllers have that option. So you can have, you know, HDMI, of course, DVI, DisplayPort, or VGA sources to display in your picture-in-picture. Now let's go ahead and demo this feature for you guys. First, let me actually go into a full display just so it's easier for you at home to see this picture-in-picture feature. Okay, let's go back. We want to go to image properties, PIP setting. Okay, once you're in your display, it's disabled, so just switch over to PIP. And boom, you will have your other source. Right now, we have our Sony PS4 playing as our other source, so we have the Avengers in our picture-in-picture. I mean, this is great for, you know, say you're watching Top Gun and your kid wants to actually watch Avengers, you know, on the same TV. Boom, you can play it there. Both of you guys can, you know, enjoy your movies. Also, we mentioned that VGA is an option that you can have in your picture-in-picture, so you could hook up your laptop while you're watching the game or movie. You can also, you know, do work at the same time, send emails, you know, do your PowerPoint, Excel sheets, whatnot. All right, so let's go ahead and also there's a lot more things you could do with the picture-in-picture. You can scale it, you could reposition it. So let us do that. Again, image properties, go over to PIP setting. Let's go to size. So on the top left is our picture-in-picture, and we can increase that size to, I guess, to 100%. And it's basically a whole quadrant, like a quarter of your, you know, fills up basically one panel of the four. Let's see, let me shrink that down just a tad. All right, we can also reposition it. Say you want it more towards the center. Boom. Let's see. You can mess with the picture-in-picture's ratio. And of course, the source, like we mentioned earlier. So if you wanted, say, to switch from the PS4 to VGA, your laptop, you can do that with the sources here. Last but certainly not least, we have Key Digital's KD-VW 4x4 Pro. Now this unit is packed with a bunch of advanced features. Let's start by addressing that this unit is capable of HDMI matrix switching. Now, for more on HDMI matrix switching, we actually made a previous video that you can check out. Click the link up above, check down below in the descriptions. The link is there as well. Right now, let us focus on the unit's video wall capabilities. Now, the KD-VW 4x4 Pro can transform consumer and professional TVs, screens, displays into a video wall with 8 different modes. So let's go ahead and check that out right now. Currently, we have our video wall set to full screen, a 2x2 setup. There are also 4 horizontal and 3 vertical video wall presets. So let's go ahead, use the front panel buttons right now, demo that for you right now. Let's say you want a 1x4 horizontal layout. You can have that. You can have a 4x1 vertical layout. You could also have 2 sets of 1x2. And you can have, if you want the picture individually on all 4 TV sets, no problem. You can have that as well. Take a quick moment, but There you have it. As we mentioned earlier, the Key Digital Unit has HDMI matrix switching capabilities. You could switch between 4 different HDMI sources and 4 different VGA sources, or any combination between the two, HDMI and VGAs. Currently, we have our Xbox One S set up as our HDMI source. We also have 2 more HDMI sources, the Blu-ray player and PS4, and we have 1 VGA source, our laptop. Now let's go ahead and demo that, and I will place each of the sources on the 4 individual TVs. All right, so let's get Mr. Tom Cruise and our Blu-ray player on screen 2, Thanos and the Avengers, our PS4 on screen 3, and on screen 4, our VGA input, the PC. Additionally, you can have it in full screen 2x2 video wall mode and switch among the sources from there as well, like so. All right, so let's get it back to our Xbox One full screen 2x2. Should be the Warriors playing. All right, so say we want Tom Cruise though to go up on the full screen. There we got Mr. Thor, and we have our laptop. Sorry, I fell asleep for a quick second, but boom, there you have the nice landscape. As you can see, I was using the front panel buttons to control all of this, but you can also use their IR remote, RS-232, or Key Digital's compass control interface. Now let's go ahead and turn this baby around, check out the back panel. Take a closer look. We have our Ethernet port, RS-232. We have our 4 HDMI outputs going to our 4 TVs. We have 4 VGA inputs, the fourth one being our PC. Right below, we have 4 HDMI inputs with 3 of them going to the different sources. We have analog left and right inputs, serial IR inputs, and our power jack. Well, there you have it. Our 4 video wall controllers all demoed for you. Everything is running nice and smoothly. Now, video wall controllers are perfect for stadiums and large public venues like hospitals, malls, airports. It's ideal for digital signage or for watching the big game, or Mr. Tom Cruise, you know, flying around in his jet. I actually wanted to talk about install earlier before our tech guy Chris rudely left.
Been here the whole time, man. I don't know what you're talking about.
Where'd that come from?
Special delivery.
DoorDash, huh? DoorDash. This guy DoorDash while we're trying to.
It was pretty quick.
All right, you know, I'm getting hungry too. Before we get to that, why don't you tell our viewers about the install? Did you run into any problems? How was it?
Install was fairly simple, pretty self-explanatory. The AvenView, you had to hook up a USB-C cable too and a LAN cable, download the software first. Geffen, pretty much plug and play. As you can see, they offer the program as well, though, if you want to do some configuring, bezel, stuff like that. ShinyBow, simple. Kind of intrigued, the fact that it's using dip switches, that's pretty cool in a lot of ways. The picture-in-picture, I dig that. For those of you out there that, you know, want that picture-in-picture and you find it hard to find or you need a special adapter, pretty cool option there. Key Digital, kind of like the do-everything guy, you know, gives you the seamless switching as well as the video wall. Again, very simple to hook up. Good to know you can get a touch panel and actually control that guy too. Yeah, so I mean, everything worked really well. I was really impressed with the setup, very simple overall. But if you got any questions, you're looking at setting one of these up, obviously you can call our sales department, tech support side of things, and we'll help you out with whatever you need.
All right, perfect, all right. But also, if you want any additional information on these 4 video wall controllers, check down below in the descriptions. We have left the product links for you all. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. You found it informational. Please share it with friends, family, peers. And don't forget to subscribe to BZB Express TV so you do not miss out on any future episodes. Oh man, I think this, my stomach is growling too now. Yes, can I?
That was
yes.
For you, man.
Is this a mini meal? All right, yes. All right, guys. See you next time.
Have a good one.